The best way to make sure that your dataset is readable both by machines and by humans is to use labels for your data. There are two important types of labels used in IBM SPSS Statistics: variable labels and value labels. We are going to dive deeper into how to label your variables in SPSS. We want to make our data set easily interpretable, so we will add some labels to our variables. First, we will add value labels to categorical variables. Our nominal variable, gender, has been coded 1 and 2. The machine can use this coding, but what we humans need to know is who is male and who is female. Click on values. We get the value labels dialog box. For the value of 1, add the label male and click add. For the value of 2, add the label female, add, and click OK. In data view, we can now toggle between numeric values and value labels. The value labels are easier for us to interpret, and any analysis that you do in SPSS will work exactly the same, regardless of whether we view value labels or the actual values. The variable marital status has been coded as a string variable. Can we reverse the process that we used with gender and just label married as 1 and single as 2? Unfortunately not. We cannot change the data by changing the labels. But the good news is that we do not have to. Provided that you have spelled each string entry the same, you can still use them in an analysis. If we were doing a t-test, for example, we could make group 1 equal single and group 2 equal married. And the t-test will still run. Or we could do an ANOVA between the groups single, married, and divorced without having to do any additional coding. It is also a good idea to use a frequency table to check that all of the strings have been spelled the same. If necessary, do the data cleaning to make sure that the spelling is consistent. In addition to defining the variable types, you can also add descriptive labels to each of your variables. The value labels, like male and female, define the levels of a categorical variable. Variable labels describe the variable itself and make the dataset easier for humans to interpret. Variable labels tend to be longer versions of the variable name. These labels will also appear in the output to identify the variables. Some variables, like age and gender, are self-explanatory, so you may choose to not add a label. Now, others, like marital or income, might benefit from a little more clarity. For the marital variable, type marital status. And for the income variable, type household income in thousands. Err on the side of using more labels than you think necessary. Someday in the future, you will look at this dataset and wonder what those short variable names meant. But future you will be eternally grateful that current you has added plenty of labels for future you to decipher. And finally, here is one more way to examine your new variables. Go to Analyze, Reports, Codebook. Move over all of the variables, and then click OK. By looking at the codebook, you can now see details about the variables and make choices about how to use them in your analysis.